Hello and welcome to a new kind of online program that you can use to generate images and computer art. I'm pleased that I can introduce you to the program PictoAI version 0.60. In this video I would like to give you a short overview over the possibilities of the program. The program is in the beta phase and can be used free of charge without any obligations. Now let's have a look to the program. When you go to the website pictoai.de, you get in the dark mode here when you don't like it. Click here to have a blue light background if you like that more. On this page you find some samples I will show you later, and where many other detailed informations. I start the program here by clicking pictoai.de. In this area is the picture you generate, and here is the settings area. You should choose your language, English, and after each setting, for example here English, you click here on the blue button, which is the refresh button. The settings of the first picture are loaded, and these are polygons, and you see there are a few settings which create such a picture. I change some settings so that you can see what different pictures you can generate. In this picture, all polygons start at the same position. It's a position is a starting point is here in the X direction. You have about 4000 pixels, and in the Y direction you have about 3000 pixels. And I click here on the random button. You see all these polygons are now anywhere in the picture. Here's a button. You can fill them, and the colors of the polygons now are here, but you can change them. For example, the red ones I make blue and choose transparency, and that will look like this. You can give the objects a random color, and so you have a great variety of colors. When I increase the number of objects, that can be any color you think of. Another setting is that we don't want to have polygons, we want branches. Each branch of an object has the same angular. I change it to 11. That gives a little bit smoother line. The objects now start all in the same direction, but you can change this with here a slider, and the computer takes any point of these limitations left and right. And now you see there are different starting directions. I make this a little bit closer so they start. The starting direction is nearly the same. You can fill some area of the object It looks a little bit like leaves, and I want that they start here in this area, so I choose with the left mouse button here an area where they should start, in the near of this area. And they're a little bit too large. You see these leaves have different size. I can make this a little bit smaller, so they should start in the near of this area. And when you don't like the random settings, you can change the global random number here, and that will produce another setting of leaves and colors. This was also done in this setting, and you can place text here in this area. Happy Easter, you see. You can place text and the position of the text and angular of the text and so on. Here is another example. We can increase the number of hearts, and that looks like this. You can place text here and so on. Another example of building a specific object is here with faces, made by with faces. It's one face, but we can increase the number of the faces. They all start at the same point. I have to click here. They have different starting points. Oh. I choose random, and so every new face has, can have a new number. It's more different colors than you see here. You can have also soft lines that you can you see here in this setting. It looks like clouds. It's because a setting of soft straights. Here you can see the clouds are made with these straight lines, but soft line. So in this way. And when you made any image, you can make this image as a background for a new image. For example, this one. That is made with polar coordinates. In this text field, you can place a function in Cartesian coordinates or in polar coordinates. So you have a wide area of drawing mathematical functions. And such a picture you can
download.
And you have that picture. Now you can look at it, and there you can see here you can see details of that picture you have created just at this moment. Yeah, you can upload your own pictures as background. Another example of Cartesian coordinates is this setting with here a waveform the amplitudes are under a sinus curve. You can choose if the axes are shown or not. Here's another example. You can change the global setting random number and you get different images. It can be 10,000 images. Or here you can see the settings for a Gauss curve. It looks like this. The Gaussian curve is also on my website. Here, there the function is specified in detail with the parameters. Here you can see the whole function. You don't see that? Now you see all, yes. Okay. The range of values for the x values must be specified here. And the parameters can be specified as a fixed value or in a range values. And here are parabols and ellipses. Ellipses in polar coordinates. Another example of polar coordinates is this picture here. So, I hope you enjoyed Picto.ai. And if you have any suggestions for enhancements, please let me know. Further spectacular program expansions are in preparation. I'm looking forward to your pictures. Thank you for your interest and goodbye.